slipping away. Isn't it a pity? Didn't find time to call.
Ready or not, gonna make it to the city. This is the night to go to the celebrity ball.
I just want to celebrate another day of living. I just want to celebrate another day of life.
Had my hands on a dollar bill, and the dollar bill blew away.
But the sun is shining down on me, and it's here to stay, yeah, yeah.
I'm telling you,
I just want to celebrate, yeah, yeah. Another day of living, yeah. I just want to celebrate.
Good evening and welcome to our show. Tonight, in a special tribute to television, our guests are Desi Arnaz, Milton Girl, Howdy Doody and Buffalo Bob Smith, Peggy Fleming,
George Bogle, Arthur Godfrey, Lauren Green, Bob Hedges,
Art Linkletter, Gail Storm,
the Osmond Brothers, our own Ice Vanities, and our special guest star, Colin. Starting our sophomore year on TV. It's a whole new season, brand new set of rules. This year, there isn't gonna be any more squabbling, no more bickering, no more fighting. Well, there goes our show.
No, I'm serious, Marie, I'm very serious. I've had all summer to think things over, and I wanna say publicly that my sister deserves credit for my success. Her steady doubt and ridicule have given me the incentive to go on, really.
Here we go again, folks.
Well, you know, you did do a lot of things last season that kind of upset me.
I did a lot of Whoa.
Name one.
The two times you punched me in the stomach.
Donnie, would I do that to you? Would I hurt my own flesh and blood?
Yours, no. Mine, yes.
Oh, come on, man. I was just a kid last season. Punching you in the stomach was just a childish reaction. This year, it's a new Marie. I'm more matured. I've changed a lot. Have you noticed the change?
Well, I guess you do seem a little older, yeah.
You're not noticing.
What?
Look, man, I'll give you a hint. It's from the neck up.
Okay.
Donnie, just look. Donnie.
Marie, you're getting a double chin. She's getting a double chin.
Donnie.
Beautiful. What?
It's my hair. See, it's my hair.
Marie, you had hair last season.
I've done something new to it. Look.
That's right. How could I be so stupid?
Yeah.
You finally washed it. She finally washed her hair.
You're really gross.
I know.
I had my hair cut. See,
oh,
it's shorter.
That's right. You did, didn't
yeah,
you?
Yeah, it's shorter.
You know, it is a little...
Do you like it?
Yeah. Yeah, I do. You want to know something? It reminds me of someone.
Mary Tyler Moore?
No.
Cindy Williams of Laverne and Shirley.
No, no. Actually, with the bangs like that and everything, it looks like Moe of the Three Stooges.
Excuse me, ladies and gentlemen, but it's time to bring back an oldie but goodie.
Oh! Ow! And I thought you were supposed to be more mature this year.
Not me, just my hair. Exciting. Start of another TV season.
Yeah, I'm really excited. You see my new dressing room?
Yeah. I love it. It's a lot bigger than last season.
Which way? Length or width?
Hey, you know, we really ought to run down that opening number. I'm not
okay.
Too sure about it.
Okay, do you remember the first step?
I think so, yeah.
Fire. Flames are getting high. Jake made you do a hitch. Come in.
Yeah. Hi. Then
that's
I turn.
Hey, they said your air conditioning was out. I'll have it fixed in no time.
Great, thanks. It's right up there.
Oh, yeah, thanks.
Do a hitch. Five, six, seven. Come in. Five.
Hey, I'm glad you're both here.
I wanted to wish you good luck, David. And take some pictures of you, okay?
Sure, go ahead.
That's good. That's good. Come in.
Hi,
Daddy. Hi, Gladys. How are you doing?
Smile,
smile,
David. I finished.
Yeah, that's
great.
Finished
Jack for the concert. You want to try it on there?
Right now?
Yeah.
Okay.
Come in. Oh, here you are,
Marie.
Try
this
on. Hi,
Kim. Sure. Hey, good luck tonight, Donnie.
Oh,
what's
thanks.
This for?
I probably got Rich Hand right in there. Come in. Hi, Jim.
Hey, Donnie, I got the music here from the road.
Oh, couldn't you put in Marie's dressing room?
Oh, Marie's dressing room looks so nice, I didn't want to mess it up. What do you want this time?
Could you put it back in the corner here? Oh, could you unload the music and put it on the shelf somewhere out there for me?
Excuse me, coming through here. Sorry.
Man!
Makeup time, Donnie.
Oh, hi.
Oh, Marie, can we touch you up first? Oh, sure, excuse me, Donnie. Come
right
here.
Thanks. Gladys.
Hey guys, hi. Hey, can I come here and practice? It's so crowded out in the hall. Can I play in here?
Let me just. Would you excuse me? Yeah.
Hey, Don,
I'm sure this would be a good time to get together with you about this new song.
Let me sing it for you.
Can you come over here?
Yeah.
Come over here.
Great.
Let me get up.
Purple sock hop.
Come in.
Purple sock hop, man.
Duda, you guys. I promise the fans out there, we signed some pictures for
them. Oh, wait.
I love that. I love that.
Has anybody got a pair of pliers?
I'll get Jimmy. Hey, Jimmy.
Smile over here.
Anybody got a screwdriver down there? A pair of pliers? All I got is this.
Sure.
Hey,
pair.
Yeah, next time get a unicycle.
I need some friends.
May have to track us on radar. Hey, would someone get the phone?
Did you want the screwdriver?
Is there a Donnie and Marie here?
I got a clean in here. Move your feet. Hey, kid, watch out. What? Hey, I'm going to leave. Come on, move. What is this?
Art Linkletter. And I'm about to prove that kids say the darndest things. Hello, young fella.
Hello.
What's your name?
Donnie.
And what do you do, Donnie?
Well, I co-star on a weekly television show. I perform in concerts all over the country, and I make records.
And what do you want to do when you grow up?
The same thing.
No ambition, eh? Well, young lady, let me ask you, what is your name?
I'm Marie.
And do you have any brothers or sisters?
Yes, brothers. There's Verl, Tom, Alan, Wayne, Merrill, Jay, Donnie.
Hold it. This is just an hour show. Now, kids, you've just been great, and I want you to have these two tickets as prizes.
Oh, thank you.
These are tickets to a special TV museum where you'll see dozens of television stars.
Oh, that'll be terrific.
Thank you very much.
Donnie? Why is Art Linkletter talking to us like we're little children on his show?
I don't know. People are funny.
And kids still say the darndest things.
A knock at the door, we got the biggest mice in Hollywood. I was right. It's mice. Big grinning mice.
Hey, is this the Television Hall of Fame?
No, it's Grauman's Chinese car wash. That's why we put the sign outside that says Television Hall of Fame.
Would you mind showing us around?
Not at all. I was just gonna take a nap. But with you two for company, it amounts to the same thing.
Hey, what is this?
Oh, that's a TV set from way back. When the screens were small and the shows were big. Now it's the other way around.
Hey, I don't recognize this man. Was he a big television star?
In a way. This is Sanford Knepp of Granville, Ohio. He's the only man in America who watched all 2,000 episodes of Lawrence Welk. And he's developed bubbles in his brain.
Hey, you know, this is all very interesting, but we were kind of hoping to see some real television stars.
Yeah.
So was I. Oh, all right, I'll take you into the main part of the museum, but stay together and don't bunch up. Now, be careful as you go through here. Some of these displays are very valuable.
All right.
This is our newest exhibit. It was donated by the Sweat Hogs from Welcome Back Cotter.
Looks like a pillow.
Wrong. It's a 5-year deodorant pad. A handkerchief once used by the $6 million man. Oh, and here's the actual Thanksgiving dinner the Waltons had 2 years ago.
Thanksgiving? That's not a turkey.
The Waltons were too poor to have a turkey. That's a meatloaf with a feather in it. Now, over here, we've got one of the most famous doors in television.
How does a door become famous?
Well, you just push the button and you'll see.
This one right here?
Lucy, I'm home!
Wow. Hey, that looked like Desi Arnaz. Can we see him again?
Sure. Push the button and you'll see a complete show.
I told you 1,000 times I don't want you in my nightclub act.
Ay, Lucy, what are you doing in that gorilla costume? Who you think you're fooling?
How was I to know it was a real gorilla?
He talks funny, doesn't he?
Hey, can we go in here?
Oh, don't touch that door. The thought of Karen Valentine and all those cute little kids makes me sick.
That was one of my favorite shows.
Hey, look, it's Bob Hedges.
Hey, Bob, what are you doing here in room 222?
Well, you see, they bust me here from Cotter's class, and then from here, zingo, right to the prom.
A break-in in room 222. How'd you like to be surrounded by a SWAT team?
You know, after a day with the guys, I could use a little quiet.
Hey, Bob, how come they bust you out of Cotter's class? Didn't they think you were learning enough?
Well, no. You see, actually, they thought we were learning too much.
Too much? Too much.
Yeah. How can you learn too much?
Well, you see, if we ever graduate, the show's over.
That's right.
Yeah. Excuse me, I'm going to go back. I'm going to clap a couple of racers.
Okay, Bob, see you later.
Wasn't that cute? You know, teenagers have always been a big part of television. I don't know what we'd do without them. But I'm willing to try. Actually, we have a lot of teenagers who honor right here in the Hall of Fame.
Oh, really? Yeah. Anybody we know?
Well, sure. We've got nice ones like the Brady Bunch. We've got tough ones like Fonzie.
Oh, yeah. We
even got some who sing.
Oh, really? Oh, I'd like to see them. I love music.
Oh, I didn't say it was music. I just said they sang. Here they are, folks. The real Hollywood Squares.
Donnie? Donnie, what are you doing?
Don't you recognize this pose? It's a classic in comedy. Jack Benny's famous pose.
Oh, yeah. Yeah, now I see it. For a minute, I was confused by your leprechaun suit.
Well, the reason I did this pose... The reason I did that pose is because we're saluting television tonight. What's more important to television than comedy?
Antennas.
TV's been loaded with comedy. For instance, Sid Caesar with his German professor routine. Dick Van Dyke tripping over the hassock every week. Oh, and the classic Soupy Sells pie in the face bit. Nothing can beat Soupy getting hit with a pie. Nothing.
Oh, I don't know about that. I remember a certain pie incident we had on our show last season.
Let's change the subject.
Hey, did any of you guys see the show where Donnie got thrown into that giant 10-foot pie?
Can you cut it out, please?
Are you sure you saw it? Huh? Do you want to see it again?
No!
You want to see it again?
No!
Okay, really, you guys!
Oh, my! Actually, I liked what happened right after that much better.
What happened? Nothing happened after that. We went to commercial.
No, we
okay,
didn't.
Okay, you guys,
no,
can
we didn't.
Yes,
wait
we did. Nothing happened.
Just
nothing. Happened.
Just on the show, we went to commercial. In real life, just a little bit more happened.
Time to sing, brother.
I don't think so, sister. I'm sure this audience wants to know what happened next, don't you?
No, you don't.
Want to see?
No.
First time ever shown. Roll it, guys.
You want to show the people Cutie Pie?
Sing, Marie.
I'm a little bit country.
And I'm a little bit rock and roll.
I'm a little bit of Memphis and Nashville.
With a little bit of Motown in my soul.
I don't know if it's good or bad.
I know I love it so.
I'm a little bit country.
And I'm a little bit rock and roll.
Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday, happy days. Saturday, what a day. Rockin' all week with you. This day is ours, won't you be mine? This day is ours, oh please be mine. Hello sunshine, goodbye rain. Wear my school ring on a chain. She's my steady, I'm a man. I'm gonna love her all I can. This day is ours, won't you be mine? This day is ours, oh please be mine. Sunday, Monday, happy days. Tuesday, Wednesday, happy days. Thursday, Friday, happy days. Saturday, what a day. I'm gonna wait with you.
Same old place that you laughed about. Well, the names have all changed since you hung around, but those dreams have remained and they've turned around. Who'd have thought they'd lead you?
much for the television documentaries. Interesting, wasn't it?
Oh, yeah, it was great. Yeah. What's next?
Now we're going from riches to rags. The wardrobe department.
All right. Okay. I'll say, is this Clumbo's raincoat?
No, it's Cher's lounging robe. Of course it's Columbo's raincoat.
How does it stay so wrinkled?
Yeah. We hired Cannon to come in once a week and sit on it.
We ought to recognize this one.
Well, you should. It's the complete wardrobe from Naked City. This is just silly novelty clothing, so let's move from the budget department to better dresses.
Okay.
You see, there was also real glamour in TV wardrobe. There were personalities who had immaculate taste, style, and elegance. Look at these three gorgeous gowns, worn by three different TV stars from the 50s, the 60s, and the 70s.
Wow, with taffeta and lace. Let me guess, okay? Loretta Young, Dinah Shore, and Cher.
No, Milton Berle, Flip Wilson, and Corporal Klinger from MASH. Of course, Milton Berle liked to wear ensembles like this one. He was the last person in television who really knew how to use accessories.
Wait a minute. Now hold it.
Stop. Hold it.
Stop the music. Would you stop the music? I resent. Sir, I resent your inference that my television appearances and performances were undignified. I'm a very, very naive person. I don't bother anybody. I don't interrupt people when they're on. Hey, kid, you're standing in my light. That's much better. I appreciate that.
Milton, you did wear a dress on TV.
Only when it was done in quiet and good taste. But all kidding aside, those were the great days of television. That's when we were having good times and happy days. Instead of watching them. But TV is a fantastic, it's terrific today, television. You can sit in your living room and watch a movie that 20 years ago you walked out on.
You see what I mean? Miss Berle, I loved your show. It was great.
Donnie, you never watched Milton Berle's show.
Sure I did.
You never did.
You were just too little.
No, I was not.
I saw it.
You never did.
Hold it. Such an argument. What do we have here? Carter and Ford? Which one is Carter? It must be Carter. Beautiful set of tooth. Now you kids know better not to argue on television. Now stop arguing, you know what I mean? And you should not argue, and you should make up.
And do what?
Make up.
Make up!
Thanks. I needed that. To think, for this I gave up watching my favorite new series, The Bionic Grandmother.
Hey, wait a minute. What show is this for?
Oh, this is the Tonight Show exhibit. Johnny's on vacation this week. We used to have a wax dummy of Johnny, but he took off too.
Hey, leave that alone.
Hey, leave that alone. Don't touch that. It's a museum piece.
Well, you don't seem to realize. You see, I'm Lorne Greene.
I don't care if you're Dale Evans. You get your paws off that saddle.
Hi, Marie. How are you?
Hi.
Well, what's the problem? You know this cowboy? Sure. He was a star of Bonanza for 20 years.
Well, you see, this is my old saddle, and I just dropped by to clean it up.
Are you saying I run a messy museum?
Let me put it this way. If something had supported you for 20 years, wouldn't you take care of it?
Well, I guess I would. Say, do you do windows?
Yep. And sometimes security guards.
Hey, see you later.
Yeah, it's good to see you.
Good to see you.
Watch that together, guys.
Would you believe it? That's a copy of the lyrics of Arthur Godfrey's theme song.
Oh, wow. Seems like old times having you to walk with.
Seems like old times having you to talk with.
Hey, that's very good. Very good. You remind me of Frank Parker.
Arthur Godfrey. Wow, it's great to meet you.
Well, I'm delighted to meet both of you.
Well, thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Arthur, it looks like your guitar shrank.
That's not a guitar, that's an ukulele,
yeah.
Right?
Well, it's an overgrown one.
Hey, Mr. Godfrey, we'd love to sing a song with you.
Oh, Mr. Osmond, I'd love to play.
Okay.
You, see if you remember this one.
All right.
Okay. You were meant for me. And I was meant for you. Patterned you, and when she was done, you were all the sweet things rolled up in one.
Ah. Yeah.
Terrific. I'm trying to conduct a tour, and they think they're Peter, Paul, and Mary.
Hey, that was really great.
Yeah, we really liked singing with you. That was fun.
Hey, can we do another song?
Oh, I'd love to, but Elton John is in town. And he has promised to show me how to make my ukulele into a pair of sunglasses. Take care, kid.
Hey, thanks a lot. Nice meeting you. Nice meeting you.
There she is, the most beautiful lady in television.
Oh, it's the Emmy Award.
Hey, wow. She's really beautiful.
Yeah,
really.
She's no Phyllis Diller.
Hey, can I touch it?
Go ahead and try. That's our alarm system. We have to protect her from all the deranged actors that sneak in here. Sure, do you have any idea what Starsky would do to Hutch for one of these? I know that was a heavy trip to lay on you, but you wanted to see the soap opera section.
Yeah.
Oh, now we come to the part of the Hall of Fame I hate. The children's shows. Last time I came through here, Ding Dong School was just letting out. And I was caught in a riptide of bubble gum. It was horrible. There's the trophy given to Winky Dinky. The first time he tied his shoelaces by himself. Unfortunately, tied one shoe to the other.
Excuse me, what time is it?
Ho, ho, it's howdy doody time.
Yes, sir.
Oh, not you again.
Why, Clarabelle, well, why aren't you in costume today?
I'm not a clown. I'm the attendant here. Leave me alone or I'll bring a woodpecker with me tomorrow.
Oh, howdy doody. I remember you. I always wanted to be part of your peanut gallery.
Gee, that's funny. I always wanted to be part of the Osmond Brothers.
just what they need, another dummy.
Hey, it's nice to meet you, Buffalo Bob. We always enjoyed your show.
Thank you.
Yeah, it's nice meeting you.
Thank you, sweetie. You know, for 13 years, Howdy had the biggest smile on television. And then you two came along. Well, you made the Doubleman twins look like crybabies.
Well, we don't want to keep the flubbadub waiting. It was awfully nice meeting you, kids.
Hey,
good
nice to see
you.
Too.
Good
you
luck,
too.
Honey.
Okay.
Bye.
See you
later.
Bye.
Let me ask you a tough question.
Okay.
Now, what do you think this is?
It's the floor.
Look again.
Oh, it's a scuff mark.
Right, at last. We had it flown out here special from New York.
Why? We have plenty of scuff marks here in Hollywood.
Because this is the spot where Ed Sullivan stood when he introduced his guests.
Like
the Marchiev Ballet, the Beatles, Elvis Presley.
Oh, neat. Hey, could I stand there?
Sure, but just don't scuff it up.
How do I look, Marie?
Well, you know how sometimes I use the word cute?
Yep.
Well, if you'll notice, I'm not using it.
Okay, Mary, but just standing here, you know, like this, it's really a kick. It's fun. I'm starting to know what Ed Sullivan must have felt like when he was introducing Elvis Presley to the nationwide TV audience.
And now, right here on our show, for all you television viewers, we're going to do a tribute to a man who needs no introduction. Let's hear it. Let's hear it for him. The one, the only. Let's hear it. Come on, come on. You ain't listening to me.
Here's what we call an audio robotronic figure.
A what?
It's a dummy. Dummy.
Hey, that looks like George Goldblum.
And you can't hardly get them no more. Now take spooky old Alice. I snuck home the other night, and let me tell you, she's got the ears of a German shepherd. I mean, she's got a nose like a bloodhound. Even her paws are... Well, about the only thing she ain't is man's best friend.
It's not very lifelike.
Neither was the original.
You see, I'm sort of new around here. The real dummy will be back tomorrow.
Oh, my goodness. It's ad-libbing, just like Westworld.
No, it's really me. I'm only standing in while they fix up my statue.
Oh, good. I like the statue better.
It really is George Goebel.
Wow.
Well, I wouldn't kid about a thing like that. You know what an honor it is to be in the TV Hall of Fame? Well, I'm more excited than a mouse in a cheese factory.
I like this story. Come on, you two.
Bye-bye. It's nice meeting you.
George. George, step down. We just want to speak to you.
Yeah.
Can I ask you something?
Sure.
What kind of jokes are you doing here?
Well,
a mouse in a cheese factory?
Well, it wasn't a big thing.
Of course it was. You heard the laugh. It was nothing. What is this? George, this is a tribute to television, so please present yourself with a little dignity. There are millions of people. There are thousands of people watching out there to pay honor to this great entertainment medium. So the least that you can do is to try to show a little class.
You know, Milton, you're right.
Sure.
You are absolutely right. I'll see if I can't come up with a little bit more in the dignity department.
You do that. You got to be very, very dignified. Because if you're not dignified on this kind of a show, it really puts down the medium. You know what I mean?
Well, that's our tour. And this brings us to our final exhibit. One of TV's outstanding comedy shows, Laugh-In.
Oh, Laugh-In was one of my favorites.
Yes, they were always pulling wild pranks. You just never knew what was coming next.
Yeah.
I hate reruns.
We now begin our broadcast day.
Historical news is being made.
The British Parliament today voted to replace the Queen with a juggling act.
Extra, extra, they're drawing a red line around the greatest scoop of the decade.
Today another Howard Hughes will was found, this one leaving all his money to Tony Orlando.
A barrel of charm, a fabulous thrill, the biggest little headline in Bonneville.
You know what I'm talking about? That Huzzy of the Hurricanes, the Siren of the Cyclones, our fabulous weather girl, who else but Miss Gale Storm? Tell them about it, honey.
Don't know why. There's no sun up in the sky. Stormy weather.
And that's the way it was.
This concludes our broadcast day. Have a very pleasant night.
Thank you, everybody. We had a wonderful time. We're really excited about starting our new season.
And how about all those great guest stars that stopped by to help us?
It's unbelievable.
Isn't that great?
Our cast looked like the Beverly Hills phone book.
We'd like to thank all of our wonderful guests.
But most of all, we'd like to thank you for sharing this hour with us.
May tomorrow be a perfect day. God keep you in His tender care till He brings us together again.
Good night, everybody.
We'd like to thank Alan for presenting his tribute to Elvis. Also appearing were Jim Connell, Kip King, Larry Larson, Thelma Pelish, Whitney Wrightbeck, H.R. Puffinstuff and Scooby-Doo, and I'm George Fenner.